Welcome to Einstein versus Tesla, a showdown of geniuses. Prepare to have your mind expanded. Gentlemen, we're here today to discuss your thoughts, ideas, and disagreements concerning scientific matters. Let's start with the fundamental nature of energy and matter. Nikola, we'll begin with you.
The world, my friend, functions on energy, frequency, and vibration. It is through this triad that we understand the universe. Currents of alternating electricity embody these principles, flowing like a river, naturally and effectively.
Your ideas are fascinating, Nikola, but they lack mathematical foundation. Energy, yes. Frequency, sure. Vibration, certainly. But the real crux lies in the interrelation between energy and matter described by my equation E.S. Clerk. Whoa! This bridges the gap between the physics of the very small and the very large.
Albert, mathematics are but tools to grasp the reality. They are not the reality itself. And your reliance on a theoretical framework, where you see energy as a direct consequence of matter, neglects the importance of the ether, the medium of propagation for light and electromagnetic waves.
Nikola, the concept of the ether is a relic of the past. My theory of relativity proved that light doesn't need a medium to propagate, making the ether unnecessary. It's not about who's right or wrong. It's about what can be proven and applied consistently throughout our scientific understanding.
Proven, you say? Your theory of relativity does a fine job of explaining the behavior of objects in space, but it fails to incorporate the intrinsic connection of everything in the universe, the unity of the field.
I concede my theories may not encompass everything. The search for a unified field theory has been a lifelong quest of mine. But to dismiss mathematics as just a tool, it's through mathematical predictions we have made great strides in technology. And it's these applications that have shaped our modern world.
And yet, Albert, your mathematics have led to the atom bomb, a weapon of unimaginable destruction. Is that your idea of shaping the world?
Nikola, it is not the tool, but the hand that wields it which determines its use. Yes, my work led to the atom bomb, but I have also advocated for its control and peaceful use. We are scientists. We seek understanding. But how our knowledge is applied is often beyond our control.
Ah, Albert, if you could see the world as I do, not as disconnected, random events, but as an interlinked, unified field, imagine the possibilities. Free, unlimited energy for all. The mysteries of the universe at our fingertips. But you insist on clinging to your abstract, detached equations.
And you, Nikola, cling to a romanticized, albeit unprovable, notion of the universe. Our disagreement lies not in our goals, but in our approaches. You dream of a world full of potential, and so do I. However, to unlock that potential, we need a consistent, proven, theoretical framework.
Very well, gentlemen. Let's shift our focus to another topic, the nature of scientific discovery. Albert, please begin.
The path to discovery, I believe, is a blend of logic and imagination. One must not be shackled by existing constraints. As I've said, imagination is more important than knowledge. For knowledge is limited, whereas imagination encircles the world.
Indeed, Albert. I agree with the importance of imagination. But your approach tends to overemphasize the role of speculation. For me, the process of discovery is an intimate dance with nature, feeling the pulse of the universe. It is less about the abstract calculations and more about intuitively perceiving the principles that govern our world.
Nikola, we cannot ignore the essential role of mathematics in making sense of these principles. Your inventions are remarkable, but without a solid theoretical grounding, they risk being accidental discoveries rather than structured progressions of scientific understanding.
You underestimate the power of the human mind's innate ability to perceive the universe's mysteries. We have an inherent connection with the cosmos, a sense of unity that goes beyond your realm of mathematical equations.
Such philosophical perspectives have their place. Nikola, but it is hard evidence, experimentation, and mathematical validation that propels scientific progress. The beauty of our universe, I believe, lies not in its obscurity, but in its comprehensibility. We, as scientists, seek to uncover its secrets, not mystify them.
We may be treading different paths, but we strive for the same destination, to unravel the mysteries of the universe. While you pursue your understanding through mathematics, I choose to engage with the natural world more directly, through observation, experimentation, and intuition.
And this, Nikola, is why our debate is so compelling. Our perspectives are different sides of the same coin. As much as we argue, we push each other towards deeper understanding and, in turn, push science forward.
Very well, gentlemen. Now let's discuss the future and the potential implications of your work. Nikola, let's start with you.
The future, my dear friends, is electric. And I mean this in the most literal sense. Wireless transmission of power, electric vehicles, unlimited free energy from the cosmos. All are within our grasp. We're just beginning to tap into the potential of this magnificent universe.
I agree, Nikola, that the future holds immense potential, especially when we understand the energy-matter relationship. However, while your visions are grand, they can also be overly optimistic and ungrounded. The universe's energy is not an unlimited free resource to exploit, as you seem to suggest. Harnessing it requires careful consideration of ethical and environmental implications.
Albert, you always seek to pin the butterfly of innovation with the pin of caution. The potential is there. What we need is the will to tap into it, to reshape society, to free ourselves from the shackles of limited resources.
Caution is not a shackle, Nikola, but a necessary part of scientific progress. You speak of free energy, yet we must also consider the implications. Unlimited power in the hands of those with ill intentions could lead to catastrophe. As scientists, we must not only push the boundaries of what's possible, but also ensure our work benefits humanity responsibly.
You're right, Albert. Science without conscience can indeed lead to disaster. However, I have faith in humanity. We must strive for these advancements while also cultivating the wisdom to use them wisely.
That's a point on which we agree, Nikola. The symbiosis of advancement and wisdom is crucial, but understanding the fundamental laws of the universe will always remain the bedrock upon which all else stands, whether it is your wireless energy or my energy. Matter equivalence. Each new discovery is a stepping stone towards a brighter future.
Thank you, gentlemen. Your shared enthusiasm for discovery and your differing perspectives have made for an invigorating debate. It's clear that while your paths may diverge, your ultimate goals of advancing human understanding and bettering the world intersect in fascinating ways. It's been a privilege to share this stage with you. Thank you for your time. Please subscribe if you are interested to see more and accompany us on this journey. Also, comment on the next debate. Who would you like to go to the debate together and what should be the topic?